the third Clark Kane in the series. It's really about a mysterious hands that are being found in Belfast. And one of them accidentally is found outside Clark Kane's apartment in the centre of Belfast. And it leads him now to a trail of vengeance. We found out later in the book that the hands have been cut off by a serial killer, but it's not the kind of serial killer that everybody expects. This time it's a group of family who are doing it against people who have murdered young children. So it's almost like a revenge serial killer family. This Clark Kane's made up of two people. One is my father, who was a socialist, a bit like Clark Kane. He always getting himself into trouble by giving money out to people and leaving himself without any money. The second one that made up Clark Kane was a guy called Rockford Files. It's an LA, Los Angeles detective from the 1970s, was on TV. He used to live on a beach inside a caravan. He never had much money. He was always taking on these cases, and the cases always got him into more trouble. He usually ended up in jail. He's a bit like me because he has a very dark sense of humor. He also has a very dark past. Terrible things happened to him, but instead of falling into misery because of what happened to him in the past, he uses what happened to him to make himself a better person and to understand the darkness which is in people rather than condemn them or judge them. I didn't want the books to be so dark that people didn't want to read them, so I needed to put a sense of humor through them. And they are very dark, but I also think they're very humorous, and anybody who reads them knows they laugh at things they shouldn't be laughing at, but that's what Clark Kane makes you do. He makes you laugh at things you shouldn't laugh at, and in a way, this helps you overcome some of the terrible things in life.